What's up, guys? Welcome back to the Star Bazaar and to another news update for Star Wars Battlefront 2. We have a small patch dropping in the game this week on Wednesday, and we just got the release notes for it. This patch includes a couple of fixes for some pretty game-breaking bugs, as well as some issues that the co-op mode had after the last Age of Rebellion update. We're also going to go into which map we think is going to come with the Scarif update, as well as some really interesting teases from our community manager, Ben. Before we jump into it, be sure to give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel for more Battlefront 2 updates like this. This is a pretty hefty list of fixes for a mid-month patch. Going right down from top to bottom, first, there was an issue where the Play Any button in co-op would not be able to matchmake you into a game, and this has now been fixed. There was also an issue that would occasionally cause a game server to matchmake players into the same team, which has also been fixed. This happened a lot in Galactic Assault, specifically on the Naboo map. There was another matchmaking issue in co-op mode, where when you would transition to a new round, you could be put onto opposing teams, and this has been fixed too. Next, they fixed an issue that would cause the AI opponents to only take one path on Jabba's Palace in the co-op defense scenario. Now they will go through all three entrances. This next one is huge. Fixed an issue that would cause a delay when attacking after evading, and this has to do with the broken lightsaber combat. In my last update video, I talked about how the lightsaber heroes will do the wrong attack in the sequence after they finish a dodge, and sometimes they will just not attack at all after dodging, which is what this fix is addressing. Hopefully after this patch, the lightsaber combat will be more fluid, like it was before. These next three are for co-op. First, set up planet-specific appearances for heroes and troopers on the Age of Rebellion maps. For example, if you're playing as the Empire on Hoth in co-op, an enemy AI-controlled Luke Skywalker will be wearing his Hoth appearance. Same would go for Leia and Han Solo. Next, they added randomization of head options for officers controlled by AI, just to give them some variation, and they fixed an issue where the AI officers on Hoth specifically would show up with the wrong names. Next, there was a pretty game-breaking bug where Yoda would occasionally be invincible against certain opponents, and that has now been fixed. They've also added more info to show how to unlock certain weapon modifications. There was an issue with the new ISB agent where she would be blocked from firing her blaster for too long after performing a melee strike, and that's been fixed. There was also a visual issue with the new Ewok Hunter's instinct ability that would show footprints on top of the trail left behind by BB-9E. They fixed an issue where snow particles would sometimes be visible indoors when playing on Starkiller Base, and they fixed various visual issues with textures popping on the Resurgent-class Star Destroyer. They've also fixed various visual and collision issues on the MC-85 Star Cruiser and Death Star 2. They've added the spear melee attack for Ewok Hunters controlled by AI, and they've made minor visual improvements to the Ewok Hunters' abilities. Fixed a visual issue where inaccurately high numbers were shown under the player damage score event after defeating an enemy. They were inaccurately high and low numbers. I once got negative 2 billion points, which was pretty awesome. Next, they added support for Cyrillic characters in the chat window when playing in non-Russian versions of the game, and they fixed a visual issue where the scoreboard would not show the accurate class level of other players, or when deploying the vehicles. Right now, the scoreboard will show other players' levels as matching your class's levels, which is not what it's supposed to do. Class levels will also now appear on the scoreboard when playing Starfighter Assault and Hero Starfighters, where it did not before. They've also removed the class level for AI players on the scoreboard, which makes sense. And finally, they fixed an issue where the button to view the profile of another player on the scoreboard would not work. While those are all the patch notes for the patch dropping on Wednesday, we have a few more tidbits of news. First, our current community manager, soon-to-be producer Ben Walk, has some insight on the ARC troopers that many players feel are a little bit weaker since the Age of Rebellion update. Before the update, players had control over the individual dual-wielding blasters, but now after the update, both blasters are assigned to a single button, which has significantly reduced the fire rate of the ARC trooper's weapon, making him a lot weaker than he was before. Ben and the team have been made aware of this, and he says that they are looking at tweaks for the ARC trooper. Next, we have a new community calendar that dropped a couple of days ago for this month that details all of the in-game events happening in March. Two of those events are tied to event-exclusive skins, the Princess skin for Leia Organa and the Farm Boy skin for Luke Skywalker. Both of these skins are tied to the in-game events, however, out on the Battlefront 2 Reddit, a couple players expressed the fact that they would not be in town for these events and they would once again miss their opportunities to get these skins. Ben reassured them out on the Reddit by saying, "We'll bring them back, likely as milestone rewards in the future, so everyone can get a chance to unlock them." By the sound of this means that these events will not be the last opportunity to get these skins, and if you do happen to miss them, in the future they'll be tied to milestones. Next, in the last community update video put out by the official EA Star Wars YouTube channel, we had a small hint at the next map coming to Battlefront 2, Scarif. It was a fan favorite map back in Battlefront 2015, and it's now back by popular demand, but after the last community update video, we had a small tease at what map specifically we're gonna get in Battlefront 2. In Battlefront 2015, we had three different Scarif maps. We had the jungle, the beach, and Landing Pad 13. Based off the short teaser that we saw in the last community update video, it looks like the map coming to Battlefront 2 will be Landing Pad 13, which was arguably the most popular out of the three Scarif maps. You can tell this is Landing Pad 13 by looking closely through the palm tree that's right in the center of the camera's view. You can see a downed X-Wing that is halfway buried in the sand, and it's the exact same X-Wing that's in the Battlefront 2015 map. I'd assume that the entirety of the Landing Pad 13 map will be used for Supremacy in a large-scale environment, hopefully even for Galactic Assault later on down the line, but this just means that a smaller portion of the map will be allocated for the smaller game modes, such as Heroes vs. Villains and possibly Blast. And finally, our last piece of news today comes in the form of a tease from Ben out on the Discord server. The last couple of days, Ben has been pretty generous with the amount of Darth Maul gifts that he's been using to respond to people's questions with, and that's led a lot of people to think that we're going to be getting Darth Maul skins here shortly. Well, out on the Discord server, Ben was asked if he had a favorite skin, and if so, what is it? Ben responded by saying that he did have a favorite skin, but he cannot tell us what it is. And that's very interesting, because that leads me to believe that his favorite skin is one that is currently not available in Battlefront 2 yet. Otherwise, why would you not be able to tell us? Obviously, this is not any kind of confirmation that we are indeed getting new skins, but couple this with the fact that Ben has been very generous with the Darth Maul gifts, specifically gifts that contain pictures of Darth Maul wearing his Rebels attire, and the fact that we're currently in the Age of Rebellion in Battlefront 2, and it kinda seems like we just might be getting some villain skins, specifically a Rebel skin for Darth Maul. This is just speculation based on the clues that we've gotten so far. Once we have an official confirmation from DICE, there will be another video giving all the details on that. But that's actually going to do it for this one. I appreciate everybody who made it this far into the video. Be sure to give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed today's coverage, drop a comment below letting me know your thoughts, and don't forget to subscribe if you're new for more Battlefront 2 videos like this. I appreciate you stopping by the bazaar, and I will see you out on the battlefront. Peace.
Our explosive charge. Engage the stormtroopers and reset our device.